What's up guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we're going to be giving you another endo top tips video, so let's just get right into it.
One of the most difficult parts of root canal treatment can sometimes be diagnosing which tooth is causing the problem. So we often do cold tests and electric pulp tests to find out which tooth might be causing the problem. But sometimes, even with that, we might not be able to diagnose exactly which tooth it is. Another technique is to do a hot test on a tooth. And in the olden days, they used to use a hot GP to do this, but we don't really do that anymore. An easy way to do the hot test now is to use a rubber dam sheet and some hot water. Get your rubber dam sheet and punch a single hole. Ask your nurse to boil the kettle and get some water that's really hot, near boiling, and ask her to put it in a syringe. Isolate a single tooth and syringe some of this near boiling water onto it. If the pulp is irreversibly inflamed, this will be very painful for the patient. Do this one tooth at a time in the area where the patient is generally feeling the pain.
For our next tip, your patients are gonna love you for it because it means giving them painless injections. Now, whenever I hear somebody describing a good dentist, they're always like, oh yeah, I went there and it didn't hurt. So the way that you can give LA painlessly is by actually moving the tissues or asking the patient to rotate their head into the needle instead of actually keeping the patient still and you plunging the needle through the tissues. And the reason it's more painless to get the patient to move into the needle is because there is less resistance on the needle. It's a bit of a gory analogy, but you can imagine that it's much less painful to fall onto a sword than it would be to plunge yourself with the sword. The way you would do this is by positioning the needle just close to the tissues and then asking the patient to actually rotate towards the needle, causing them to be injected by themselves. And that would actually be much less painful. One of my retired clinicians actually did this exact same thing on me, where they were giving me an IDB and I actually didn't even realize they had given me an IDB at the time, because what they did was they actually moved my tissues into the place of where the needle was and then took it out again instead of keeping me still and injecting me. Before we move on guys, it really helps us with the YouTube algorithm if you were just to quickly like the video and subscribe to our channel so that our videos reach out to more people. Thank you.
The next tip is for those irreversibly inflamed pulps which just keep on bleeding and you can't control it. Once you've gotten access to the pulp and it starts bleeding, what you can do is place some topical gel on a little cotton pledger and put it into the pulp chamber and hold it for 5 minutes. The topical anaesthetic has a very high concentration of LA and that should help the bleeding. And this is also helpful when the patient can sometimes feel the pain, because the coronal pulp chamber in those scenarios are the ones which are most inflamed and most difficult to get numbed up.
Our fourth tip is short and sweet. Once you've gotten access, your next step is to de-roof the pulp chamber. And to help you do this and make your life so much easier, get the tip of a BPE probe or the end of a Briot probe and just check for undercuts. Then extend your access in that direction.
Our last tip is to help you shape lower first molars. Out of the mesiobuccal and the mesiolingual canal, the canal that you should prepare and shape first is the mesiolingual. The reason we do this is because the mesiolingual tends to be wider canal and easier to prepare than the mesiobuccal. But also, in quite a lot of cases, the mesiobuccal canal tends to join the mesiolingual canal towards the apex. And so if you prepare the mesiobuccal first, you might end up perforating or causing ledges in the mesiolingual. So first, shape your mesiolingual and place a GP point all the way to apex. Then take out the GP point, and if you see a small dot on there, you know the mesiobuccal has joined the mesiolingual and hit your GP.
All right, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys found this video useful. And if you did, feel free to subscribe, share, and like this video. We also have another top 5 endo tips video, so feel free to check that out. And hopefully we'll see you guys in the next video.